this type casting. So yeah, type casting I told you, if given you have taken one data type and you want that output as a different data type version, so that you can type cast it. So there are two ways of defining. Screen is visible. In this, what we have done, so it, just I'm showing the type casting in two ways we can do. So what we will do, so small program only. I have taken a my class, the class name I have taken. So I have taken a public static void main string args. This is the main method. And if you see, I will write int a equals to 9. So I have taken a value a equals to 9. So I want to convert into, I will assign the value a value. What is the a value? 9 to b. And the data type of b is a double type. So this is known as automatic casting. No need to cast the variable. Clear. You can directly do it. So what will be the output? The output will be 9, because as the a is integer over there, so the output, if you print the value a equals to 9, and if you take it value as double, so double means floating point value, so 9.0. So it is the automatic casting over there. The screen is visible. Hello.
Yes, sir.
So this is another class, same class, my class to same conversion. I am automatic casting, and this manual casting, or you can type cast. What you will do? Suppose I will take a double value as 9.78, clear. Or I want to convert into an integer type. So this is the function. Within bracket, I have to highlighted the int. So which data? If you want to int, you can print it, clear. Because here it is double, clear. If you want float here, then you can do float here. Clear. So like this, it is known as a manual casting over there. So if the, you run this, you will got this output, this one. Okay, so same thing I have taken. So the fastest compilation Java C. What is the file name is there? My class dot Java. Java, my class. See, in the first I have taken the data type as integer. I want to convert it to die type, so manually I can do double b equals to a. So another I have taken for the auto, this is automatic, otherwise manual casting you can say. What is that class name? I done my class. What is the class name here? It is taking this class 2. It is yes, because we have converted into integer means 9.8 is getting, we are getting so over there. This is a small example. Variable name also we have discussed. What is the variable scope of the variables? So in the previous class, I've told you the scope of the variable. So the scope of the variable lies between the final braces of the block, that is opening bracket to the close bracket. So if you take any variable in the class, suppose if class A, you are writing public static void main, and within the main method, what will be the value variable you are using? The value scope will lies within this only. This variable exists only inside the code block in which it will be declared. That means we, on which block you have defined the variable, on that only that variable is accessible. So this is known as a variable scope. So if you see, this is a small code only. It is public sum method. So it is a method over there. In this method, he has taken a game score. Score is another score is a variable, and high score. You have taken a string name, system dot out dot enter the name. If the name is next line, okay, this is not needed right now. We'll not fidget on this code right now. Yeah, next one is your arithmetic operators over there. I already give you an assignment, correct or not? Write a program, take two numbers, you have to do all the arithmetic operation, correct or not? Have you done? Yes or no? I want. How many have done? Done or not? Arithmetic operation. Simple question. Take two variables. What? Tell.
In C program, we did it, sir. Arithmetic program operators.
I want in Java. C is there. Okay. C is gone. C is semester, first semester for you.
Yes, sir. Wait.
But in Java, how to do? Why? Because I'm asking, when you write many number of programs, your syntax, your commands you will know how to write the Java code. Similar way, what is the functionality you are doing in programming? See, same logic will be applied, but the syntax and the structure is going to be changed. That's why if you do not practice, then see, if you think Java is easy, everything is easy, but when you at the time of examination, you will all forget the syntax. What is the syntax will be there? What is the syntax error you are getting there? So when you run a file, if an error is coming, from that error, you know which one is correct or not. Just tell me, till now, how many have you executed hello, print hello also in Java? See, if you have to execute only, then only you can fill the programming of Java. Otherwise, this subject, if you not execute in the class, what I taught, if you not execute, then again come back with the class, then the things I will tell you will go over your head over there. Clear? Because it is initially, it is okay, one to this, up to five or six classes, it is common to the book. But once the Java concept start, every class is interlinked. So one, if you skipped one, two classes, in the upcoming class concept, you will not find it. You will not get it. So that's why it's a sincere request. Please execute. Just only small programs are there. So everything I will share to you, but you have to make a practice, then only. Till now, how many Java you have installed? Till now, only one or two are installed. If you are not installing, please install it. Otherwise, for the timing, you can do online Java compilers are also there. That is the basic advantage nowadays. Without installing also, online Java compilers also are available, various Java compilers. Okay. So, first program, what we have done? First program, print hello. Next program, what we have done? Input all type of data types, print, read it and display it. Clear? Next program, what you have done? Addition of two numbers, like typecasting and all. So, small program will say addition of two numbers. So what I have done? So, this is the existing program which I have already shown you. Just addition of two number. Or we can do int. We'll change the class name. We'll do some input. You'll write class algebraic operation. Algebraic. Algebraic operation. Public static main, I have written two value. Clear? Then what I have taken? I have sum to print the value summation. I will take a MUL value for multiplication. I will take a DIV value for division. Clear? So then I have using the input from the user end. So I have taken scanner in. You can change also. I will change the object name. Suppose I will change the here SC. Scanner SC equals to new scanner system.in. then enter the integers. So you have to enter the integers. You have to access the next int function with the help of object of the scanner class. This is the object of the class. So this is known as sc.nextint. Similarly, sc.nextint. Then sum equals to a plus b. Then I will calculate the multiplication value mul. Multi is equals to a cross b. Then another I will calculate. So division will be calculated. Then I have calculated some multiplication region. Simply I will going to print it, the print the values. It's the same system dot out dot println. Instead of writing, I'm just copy pasting because I am doing operating on three variables. So first I will do addition of two number sum, then the multiplication. So in between this, what you will write is going to display in the output screen. Multiplication of two numbers is, what is the variable I have taken here? Mult, M-U-L. Plus, if you write mul also, println, system.out.println, you write it. println. Next one is, this is the... division of two numbers. What is the variable I'm taking? DIV. Also plus. So this is a small program for addition of two numbers, multiplication, division. So small algebraic operation. So how to store it? So what is the class name I have taken? This one, algebraic operation, control C. I have to save. How to save it? Save as file name dot java. Is it visible to all?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Then you make it save. Then on which file you have stored it, that java file has been stored. Clear? Next, we go for the compilation.
Yes, sir.
Java C algebraic operation. How to compile is, syntax is Java C file name dot Java. This is a syntax. Okay.
No, sir.
Then I have to. Not visible, huh? Screen is visible or not?
Yeah, I think so.
Visible, huh?
Okay.
See, if this one is the use code for compilation, Java C file name dot Java. Clear? So whatever the file name you are giving, you have to give the appropriate name. If you not give the appropriate name, then it will say that file name is missing in that. So in order to run this file, Java file name. Okay. So enter the integers. So a value after integer. So I am entering as 5. Clear? Enter the b value. Sorry, a value 10 and b value is 5. Addition is 15. The multiplication of two number is 50. The division of two number is 2. Clear? So it's a small program. Clear if you see this output. This is the output statement, integer 10, integer first I have taken 10, 5, addition of two numbers 15, 50 and 2. So like this small program you can do using operators. So I have taken two integer numbers, you take two tuple numbers. Please mute, I am having some background noise. If you have any doubt, you unmute and speak. Clear. So this is the scenario. You can take, I have taken integer number. You take two double number and see how it is happening. Clear? So these are the operation. So plus modulo, you can do increment and decrement. What is the increment operator do? If a value x equals to 5, I'll make it increment. So there are two types, post increment and pre increment. Similarly, decrement is also pre and post over there. So we'll go that one. So this is the some code is written, arithmetic expression evaluate following the orders. Yeah. So there is a order of execution of the parentheses and bracket will be there. So yeah, according to the expression. Screen is not visible, huh?
Visible, sir.
Not visible, sir.
Visible, sir.
Okay. So if you check the increment and decrement operator, increment decrements are handled first for pre-increment notation, last for post-increment notation. Increment in Java means to add one to the variable, decrement means you have to subtract on the variable. You already know it. So this is known as your pre-increment notation and this is known as a post-increment notation. So here is an example it is given. If you are taking consider the case of pre-increment. So if you take int x equals to 3 and you make a pre-increment x plus plus a, clear? So in this case, it is equals to, you have increased the value. What means in the pre, it will increase the value and then we'll go for storing it. That means your 3 value is increased to 4, then it's stored 4. Then again, you are doing x equals to plus plus x. So again, it will increment 5 and it is going to store. So finally, if you print the value of z, the output is going to be print as 5. So this z is equals to 5 over there. Similarly, same way, in case of post increment, if you take x equals to 3, it will be first stored, then it will increment. So 3 is stored first, then you increment to 4. So here, if I'll take z equals to x plus plus means the value of 4 will be stored to x, then it is going to increment. So z is equals to 4, but x is equals to 5. You print the value of x. Here, if you print the value of z, the value will got 4. And if you print the value of x, the value will get it is 5 because it is post increment. Post increment, what will say is the value will be stored first, then it will be incremented. Here, 3 is there, means x value 3 will be stored at first, then it will increment at 4. Now the x value is 4 over there. But in case of z equals to x plus plus means what is the previous value of? So x plus is 4. So 4 value will store bit of z, then the 4 value is incremented to 5. But when you go to print of z value, it is print the value of 4 and the x value is equals to 5 over there. So you can hit and trial this. That means you take a 1 and 2 value, you run the what you are getting or not, make the 2 variables, define, you take 2, read 2 variables, make increment operators and see what is the printing you are getting, correct output or not. Next one is your assignment operators. So already you know, if you are using equal sign, you are assigning the value. That means here, that's 4 value is... This 4 value is assigned to x over there. Your 5 value is assigned to y. Your z value is assigned to z. 10 value is assigned. So total. So these are the memory allocation you can see for assignment operator. Okay. So if you see this one, if you see total equals to this one. So I have taken x equals to 4, y equals to 5 and z equals to 10. So I have to calculate this mathematical equation. Clear? So how many operators are there? 2 operators. So one is operator is plus, another operator is multiplication. So among these 2 operators, which one will be executed first? So according to the precedence rules of the operators, multiplication will be done first. Correct or not? So that's why 5 cross 10, 50. 50 plus 4, x value is 4. So output will equal to 54. If you see x equals to 4 here, here 5, here z equals to 10, and the total output is 54. This is the expression. Similarly, if brackets are there, you have to perform the operator of diagram according to the formula of precedence order of execution. In mathematics, we already know the execution flow or execution of algebraic expression. The same way, the mathematics compiler also has been designed. It follows the same. So this is just showing the expression of algebraic operations. Similarly, so another expression is that it is given in bracket formula. The same value, same. We have taken x equals to 4, y equals to 5, z equals to 10 over there. Then we calculate the total, but here introduce a bracket as well as multiplication. So according to the rule, so which one will be executed first? The bracket thing will be executed first, then followed by the multiplication, then followed by the. So what will be the output here? Can anyone tell? So what will be the total here?
34, sir.
Yeah, so what will the z value is 10, 10 minus x is 4, so 6, y value is 5, 6 cross 5 is 30, and x value is 34. Fine, very good. So output will be 34. So this is a small example of executions over there using algebraic operations. Yeah, 34, the same solution it is given. Yeah, this is truncation in integer division. Yeah, fine. This is also, I'll show you an example. So what is the truncation part? If you see, here, just see this, 16 divided by 3. So what will be the 5 divided by 3. So 3 fives are 15. So remainder 1 is getting. So truncation is nothing but it will show the quotient part. Quotient part it will show the. And 1 is the remainder. So the truncation, it will be the 5 over there. So what will be the truncation value? It will the what will be the quotient part of the by the number is act as the truncation. Similarly, if you take 10 divided by 3, so 3 is a 9. So 1 is a remainder is 1. So the truncation part will be the 3. This one you already know remainder operator. 3 5 is 15, remainder is 1. So 1. So 3 12 modulo operator 3. So 3 4 is 12. So remainder is 0. The output is 0. Clear? Then 11 modulo 3. So 3 3 is 9. So 2 remainder. So if you will write modulo 1 modulo 5, what will be the output? What will be the output? 1 modulo 5.
1, sir.
Yes, thank you. So the value will be 1. Because 1 is cannot be divisible by 5. So there will be remainder by default 1 will be there. So it will be 1. These are small examples are there. Yeah, same thing. Okay, this is okay. This is, see this example. It is a small concept, but very, very important. So here x equals to 4, y equals to 5, and z equals to 10. And you have taken total equals to x divided by x cross y. So according to this, bracket operation will be do first. So 5 cross 10 equals to 50. X value 4, y value is 5. So 5 cross 4, 20. Z value is 5. So 5 by 20. So what will be the value? 4, 10, 4, 20. Okay. 10 by 20. So value equals to total equals to 1 by 2. Correct or not? So when you get 1 by 2, means it equals to 0.5. Clear? Here we are total getting as point value. Point equals to total equals to 0.5. But the integer, the total value is a integer over there. Clear? But you are getting the value as 0.05. You are getting a floating point value. So it will take only the integer part. So that's why it will not going to display 0.5, because here you define the total variable as integer. For that reason, it will take the only take the integer part only. If I'll change it, I will make it double total equals to this one, then 0.5 is going to be displayed. So this is the motto of saying. So whatever the data type of the variable you are defining, depending upon that constraint, it is going to print the variable. Yeah, same thing, it is also another given, double. If you see, double he has taken height equals to 4, radius equals to 10, and volume you have to calculate. So this is the formula, 1 by 3 into pi r cube, pi r square h. So this is the formula. So depending upon this, you can calculate. Suppose, why this is given? Suppose I will ask you, write a program to calculate the area of a triangle. So you already know, half into length into breadth. So you can write a small Java program to calculate the area of triangle, rectangle, as well as area, perimeter, everything you can find for a cylinder. You already know the formulas. So you define the variables and calculate the volume, area, perimeter of any shape. It may be a rectangle, triangle, square, rhombus, or trapezium, or any side. Inside will be there. Depending upon this, you can find it. So these are the small example also. If you want to do, you can do it. Calculate the area of triangle as well as the perimeter. So like this. And this conversion I already told you, very, very important. If you are getting the output here as a integer, but you are defining this value, definitely you will got a double value because it's a decimal value is there. So it is going to print the double value. Double value means it is a floating point value, but the size is more than the floating point value. So all the floating point value directly goes to the double. If you define double value, by default the floating point will be covered.
The screen is not visible, sir.
Not visible, huh? I didn't change anything.
Not visible, sir.
Okay. It will take some time, okay. Shuffling in the side, it will take some time, okay. No need to worry, it is just small things over there to type casting operators. Now the if you type cast operator is visible.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so same thing. So I have taken int whatever the example I have shown you before type casting, the same example I have taken. So integer int number you have taken. So number is equals to int of max. So this is the for the timing you do for creating an random number. Suppose if I want to create the random number between 1 to so 0 to 1. So what will be the number of random numbers? N number of random numbers can be generated from 0 to 1. So this is a mathematical function, math.random. It will create random some value. Whatever the random value will created, it will be multiplied by the 10. And it will be typecasted as integer. So I'll get an integer value. If the math.random function, even if generated point value, suppose 0.8, into 10, so you are getting an integer value. If you are generating 5.6.7, suppose into 10, so 56.7. So integer means only 56 is going to the output. Next one is converting string data types. Okay. Yeah. Now this is very, very important. Okay, string class will cover now. I'll not go to the string conversion right now. Understanding. And this is already I've told you implicit int is there depending upon the data type of the variable which you want to go into print it. That is very, very important. So if you see this picture is visible. Cat.
Yes, sir.
See this example of showing if you are actually the data is cat type, but you want to show in larger frame. So that is known as type casting. You're framing a small variable to into larger space. That is known as a type casting. You can say, suppose here integer 5 is an integer. Clear? So you want to present in a double value. So you are presenting the integer value in a bigger manner. So this is the example meaning, the picture format saying about that. And this, then searching through the Java API, navigate this library, yeah. The screen is visible API, application program interface in the Java, clear. There are certain application program interface. It contains the compiler, which contains some predefined methods. Suppose if you want to calculate a square root of a variable, SQRT, so there is a predefined method. Power a to the power b, if you want to calculate power POW a comma b, same thing that you have studied in programming C also. So through this API, you can call these methods. So the major benefit is to having the access of the Java API to common concept programs called as reuse. Clear? That means already the code is present in the predefined method. You want to just use it. Square root of a number, cube root of a number, power of a number, clear? Log of the function. If you find log a base 10, so there is a log method is there. Clear? So different method is there. If you want to use it, just access it. Rather than coding the access item, you may use the API to find how to access the existing code, and that does exactly what you want. So already the predefined code method or code will be there, you just call it. Everything will be accessed, as I told, in Java. In C there is a header file concept, in Java there is a package concept. So everything will be mentioned in a package. Similarly, in your programming C, there is a math.h, math header file you are using. Similarly, here also Java also contain a math package, java.math.lang, math. Math packages are there, where this all the mathematic functions are present. You have to import it. Import java.util.star, import java.math.h. Math.star, so some certain will be there. If you want to know what are the APIs are there, so if you have downloaded the Java in your system, you go to the online versions, it will show docs oracle.java sc 7. So it will show what are the APIs are there. If you want to know in your Java what are the different APIs are included while installing your Java, this is the console of that, where you can check what are the APIs by default installed by the Java. If you go for download Java, first you have to go to Oracle ID, then you have to register using a Gmail ID. After entering, you can do it. Next one. This is the screenshot is given, platform 7 edition. So if you go this here, somehow it is present. So this is from the data type and operator practice question. You can do it. So already you have practiced, so you can directly print also. If you can execute this one also directly, if you'll write system.out.println x plus y, it will add it and display the value. No need to take the third variable. In that way also you can do. This is the example of showing in that manner. Clear? So the terminology is what we have discussed: arithmetic, assignment operators, boolean characters, convention, declaration, double. So these are the basic things we have discussed. Write a program to find the greatest among two numbers. You can do it or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So the same structure, the flow of controls. So conditional statement. So what is a conditional? So conditional statement says that you have to check a condition, whether it is satisfied. If it is satisfied, it will goes to print the output. If it is not satisfied, what going to print? So this is known as your flow control. So in your flow control, the first thing is your control statement. In that control statement, there are three types of there. One is a selection set statement, iteration statement, and jumping statement. My screen is visible?
Yes, sir.
So these three statements, if you covered, all things is going to be over. What is that? Selection statement is one is an if else is there, clear? If else, else if flag, else if is also there, no problem, clear? Switch case is there. So these are known as selection statement. What is a selection? That means if along with a condition will be checked, if the condition will be satisfied, it is going to print the below. If else, what will be there? If the condition is satisfied, it is going to print the if block. If the condition is not satisfied, it goes to the else block. So according to the formula, according to the concept, if in programming, if there is a if, there must be an else. So no if cannot be executed independently. So if there is a if statement, there must be an else part. Clear? Next, switch case it will take. Switch case also is just like it will give a group of options. So that switch case A, case B, case C. So different case will be occurred. So if any of the case will going to satisfy, it is going to print it. For iteration, so while loop, iteration means iteration. Number of times will be iterated depending upon the condition. Suppose I will ask you, write addition of from 1 to 100. Clear? Make a while loop. You can add it from 1 to 100. Clear? So while loop, for loop is also same. The while loop, for loop, and do while loop. So what is the difference between while and do while loop? Can anyone explain? You already know. What is the difference between while and do while? Can anyone explain what is the difference between while and do while?
While loop.
Yes.
While loop evaluates the condition first, then execute the statement.
Yes.
Do while first execute the before the evaluating the condition.
Yeah, okay, correct. What he says, while loop satisfied when the condition is correct. If the condition is not correct, the while loop is not going to execute. But in do while case, even if the condition will be false, the do while execute at least once. Clear? So this is the main difference between while and do while. And for loop also, you know how to represent. Next is the jumping statement. So what are the jumping statements? Are break. Break means to come out of any looping. Suppose you will write while loop. In between the while loop, I'll make a break statement. That means after executing, it will just come out. Continue means it will goes on continue. And return means it will return a value. So we'll go one by one. This is a simple if else statement, you know. If you have to input a statement, if it satisfies, clear, true, then it goes to the statement block. If false, go to the next statement. It will just a comparison will be there. For that reason, if an expression will be compared, this is the condition. If it is satisfied, it goes to the printing the statement block. If it is not, it going to the next statement over there. Clear. So if you check this one, this is a small example you have taken. Public static test will be there. Public static void main string args. If the value is x, I have assigned the value x equals to 5. Clear? Here the condition is checks x is less than equals to 20 or not. X is less than 20, correct? Because the assigned value is x equals to 5. So this is if statement. So this if block is going to be executed over there. Similarly, if else statement, if you check it, if is followed by a condition over there, if it is satisfied, it is going to execute the if block. If it is not, the condition is false, then it will execute the by default the else part. Okay. So same representation is there. So if it is true block, if it is false, goes to false block and it will execute over there. The example, yes. So this is the example. If you see, this example says about voting system. Clear? If a candidate is there, write a, suppose the question will become, write a program to check whether the person is eligible to cast his vote or not. So what is the condition is there? You already know, if, according to the government, if the age is greater than 18, he is able to cast his vote. So same thing, what I have done. So I will take the, here I have taken any class name you can take, clear, then public static void main, this int age. I have taken a age parameter, clear. In that age parameter, if the age is greater than 18, I have make a if else statement. If the condition is age greater than 18, then print it is eligible to vote, clear. Else, if the age is less than equals to 18, then the person is not eligible to vote. Clear. And see this line, this integer parse int args of L. So here, by writing this, if you this see this one, what is the meaning of writing this one? Here he has taken command line argument increment. Clear. Before we have taken scanner class, but it is a way to read the command line argument. What is command line argument? So if you see public static void main string args, here the main methods is takes a string args, that means an array of characters over here. So this is the command line argument. So whatever the method argument you are passing, here it is going to be stored. Clear? So int age, if I'll write here int age equals to 20, so no need to write this one. Clear? If I'll write int age only and age this one, what will happen? While compiling Java C dot file name, it will compile and it will wait to input your value. Here the compiler, if you write Java C that file name, the compiler will wait the user to input a value. So whatever the input you are giving, it is directly showing to the directly going to the edge. Clear? Suppose by using scanner class, what will happen? You are using a scanner sc equals to new scanner system dot in. Then you are writing age equals to sc dot next int by using a scanner class concept previously. So here it is taking only the command line argument to execute. We'll execute this one also, no problem. For the timing, you just know it. File like this, it is the why it is args of 0, because it is the first number you are storing, because as you know the array elements starts from 0th location. So whatever the value is going to age equals to args of 0. This is the command line argument input. Clear? So this is a small program. If I'll give you, write a program to find the greatest between two numbers, okay, greatest between three numbers. Clear? Suppose I will give you, find the check whether suppose I will question give you find and check the condition of the root square of what is calling it, maybe so if I say according to the quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c, check the condition whether the roots are exist or not. If exist, make a statement. That means ax square plus bx plus c. So I will input the a value and the b value and the c value. Clear? Then I will calculate the decision parameter. What is d equals to b square minus 4ac. Correct or not? If the b square minus 4ac is equals to 0, that means you have to print both the roots are equal, that is x1 equals to x2. Clear? If the b square minus 4ac is greater than 0, you print the quad, the both roots are real and distinct. Clear? And third case I will check, if the b square minus 4ac is less than equals to 0, then the roots are imaginary. Are you able to got it? Everyone follow the question?
Yes, sir.
Hello. Yes. So this is the assignment to you. Clear? First program you have to, what is the program today I have discussed? So this program you can do. Next program is write a program to calculate the area, perimeter of rectangle, triangle. Clear? Another program I am giving you, perform the, what is this one. If I'll include calculate, just display the condition of the quadratic equation. So quadratic equation to find the values of that variable. Suppose ax square plus bx and c. So input, take a variable a, take a variable b, and take a value c. Clear? Then calculate the decision parameter d. So d is equals to b square minus 4ac. We have to check the three condition. If b square minus 4ac satisfy, b square minus 4ac equals to 0, print system dot out dot println, both the roots are equal. Next condition you have to check, if d square minus 4ac is greater than 0, system dot out dot println, the roots are different, both the roots are equal and the roots are real and distinct. Another case you have to check, if the d square minus 4ac is less than equals to 0, system dot out dot println, the roots are imaginary. Clear? So this is the assignment to you. Come, you execute this one. At least I will try. You execute, if you execute the commands, you know. So if you have the error, save it and tell me what is the error you are getting. If you got the output, well and good, show me. Clear? So okay. Okay, okay, I'm winding up here. So tomorrow in the class we'll discuss following, else if we'll complete this control statement. So I am not going in deep. You already know what is if else statement. So you execute one or two program so that your whatever the you have done previously, you'll get a recall. Same thing, but how to frame it in Java, you have to check. So if same what you are doing in C, the same way, but you have to place in the Java code. That's it. Clear? In the next class, we'll show, okay, beta is operator. Okay, so I'll tell you in the next class how beta is operators are there. What is left shift operator? What is right shift? Depending upon this, if else. Clear? So what you have studied in C, that is C, if else, switch case, everything is same here. For loop, while loop, everything is same. Okay, thank you.